Willumbin, the cloud catcher. And over there's Mount Nardi. I'm Thundercloud, and I'm in a githable country, in a place known as now as the Border Rangers National Park. I came up here for a reason. A special reason. I came to speak for the trees. Up here, there are trees that are 2,500 years old. They're older than me and you. This is ancient rainforest. Can you imagine if it was cut down? Out there. Many years ago, down in the valley, here in the big scrub, 99% of it was cut down. And this is all that's left. But that's not why I'm here. We have to save the trees. The trees in eastern Victoria, in the way of the eastern freeway, on Japwarung land. The Victorian state government wants to cut down 800-year-old trees. 800! Do you get it? 800 years old. Where there've been babies born forever. Those trees, they have been giving oxygen to humanity, not asking anything in return. All their life. And now they want to be cut down. They don't want to be cut down. They don't want to be cut down. I speak for the trees. And the trees are sad. And they're crying. Because they want to cut down the old ones. In this area, here, where they cut down 99% of the forest, there used to be trees over 100 metres high. And the lowest branches were just 30 metres. And you could walk around in the open underneath these giant trees. But then the loggers came and they cut down trees that were thousands of years old. And sent the wood all the way back to England and Europe to make furniture. That's colonization. And forced the Githabal and the Bunjalung and the Widjibal and the Wyabal and the Yugambeh people off their land. And then they weren't allowed to go there and hunt. And now they're doing the same cultural genocide in Victoria. They want to take away a birth tree, an 800-year-old birth tree of the Japwarung people. So I'm Thundercloud and I speak for these trees, and I'm not happy. I want you to share this video about, share it wide and far, and make sure that Victorian government hears, because this is important. It's time that we started to look after and nurture the planet. Ancient trees feel no pain. They drink up the pouring rain. Yeah, there's a man you might all know. He lived over 2,000 years ago. But there is a tree that still has leaves. And it's lived more than 2,000 years. And it grieves up in the highest mountain reaches of the ancient Antarctic beaches, patiently waiting, wet and dry, breathing sun, the air and sky. Antarctic beaches, watching people, the churches crumble and the steeple, will all die and fade away. But ancient trees still laugh and play. When I die, please put my skin in the ancient beech forest within. The thunder clouds will bring a fountain here upon the highest mountain, and I will live forevermore as an ancient beech on the forest floor. I sit, I stand, I speak, I weep and cry, happy about the day I die in January 2083, I'll be here with the Antarctic beech trees. And hopefully those trees in Victoria will still be alive and not cut down and under a road. One love, one heart, one earth, one biosphere. We are one. Share. Share this video wide. Lots of love for the planet. Look at that pinnacle over there in the sunlight, so people can come and enjoy ancient trees forevermore. And I don't have to cry anymore when they want to cut down fucking trees. All right, I'm Thundercloud, washing away the garbage and leaving behind rainbows. See you later. Boom.